Assalamu alaikum student, this is your Pakistan Study P1 unit. Today we start a new chapter number 14, that is Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto, a time duration 1971 till 1977. Introduction of Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto, your chapter. On 5th January 1928, Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto was born. He belongs to a Sindhi landlord family. He became president in 1971 till 1973 and prime minister of Pakistan from 1973 till 1977. He was a popular leader who was overthrown and executed by the military. Bhutto studied law at the University of Oxford and then practiced law and lectured in England. Upon his return to Pakistan in 1953, he set up a law practice in Karachi, where he was appointed a member of Pakistan's delegation to the United Nations in 1957. After Muhammad Ayub Khan seized the government in 1958, Bhutto was appointed as a commerce minister and then held other cabinet posts as well. After his appointment as foreign minister in 1963-66, he began working for greater independence from Western power and for closer ties with China. Means he worked hard to become independent, not under the control of the Western power, and instead making a friendship relationship with China. His opposition to the peace with India after 1965 war over Kashmir caused him to resign from the government. The Tashkent Declaration. It was a humiliating declaration which was forcefully signed by Pakistan in 1965 after 1965 war. Ayub Khan blamed him for the cause of 1965 war as he was the foreign minister at that time. Due to this reason, he resigned, and in 1967 he founded the political party called Pakistan People's Party. After the overthrown of Ayub Khan regime by General Yahya Khan, national elections were held in 1970. Although Bhutto and his party won a sweeping electoral victory in West Pakistan, the biggest election winner was the Awami League, an East Pakistani-based party that had campaigned for full autonomy for East Pakistan. We have discussed these all in previous chapter number 13. Okay? Bhutto refused to form a government with his separatist party, causing a nullification of the election. The widespread rioting that followed degenerated into civil war, after which East Pakistani, with the help of India, emerged as an independent state of Bangladesh. After West Pakistani humiliating defeat by India in his military conflict, Yahya Khan turned the government to the Bhutto on December 20, 1971. In 1971, he became the first civilian chief martial law administrator. In this way, Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto took the control of West Pakistan. Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto's success and failure. Today in this unit, after the introduction, we will discuss in detail about the successes of Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto. First of all, in 1973 constitution, he presented a comprehensive constitution which is still used in Pakistan with some amendment or implementation of other laws. Okay? Then he introduced reforms in the field of land, health, education and administrative reforms. He controlled the army and signed Simla Agreement in 1972. Today we discuss the successes in detail. Okay, first of all, controlling the army. Our country was under the control of army. Previously there was a Yahya Khan government and the Ayub Khan, both were the military man. That is why army was having a great influence in the government. So he limited the power of army by removing the three important army leaders. 29 in Bhutto's first 4 months, he removed most of the important army leader, 29 in first 4 months. Okay? Among them were the three main leaders as well. First, the head of the Air Force, Air Marshal Rahim Khan, and the Commander-in-Chief of the Army, General Gul uh, हसन एंड देन ही रिप्लेस्ड हिज ओन आर्मी ही अपॉइंटेड हिज ओन लीडर जनरल तीका खान एंड ही सेट अप द FSF. FSF इज फेडरल सिक्योरिटी फोर्स. सेकेंडली सिमला एग्रीमेंट ऑन 2 जनवरी 1972 भुट्टो साइन सिमला एग्रीमेंट विद द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया इंदिरा गांधी. This was the agreement signed to after 1971 war. In this agreement, India agreed to return prisoner of war which they were captured during 1971 civil war in East Pakistan, and almost India captured Pakistan 6,000 acres of land which he promised to return. And in return, obviously, Pakistan agreed not to raise Kashmir issue in international forum or UNO. So on that basis, Simla agreement was signed in between the two countries. It was a great success or achievement for Bhutto because 93,000 prisoner of war, 93,000 soldiers were huge number. So that is why their family suffered, obviously Pakistan armed forces, men arrested by the Indian government. So release 93,000 prisoner of war was a great success for Bhutto at the time when country was suffering with the loss of 1971 war as well as loss of one of the wing of Pakistan, that is why East Pakistan. Then he presented 1973 constitution. After taking control of the government in 1971, Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto started work on a democratic constitution for our country. On 17 April 1972, the National Assembly constituted a committee to prepare a draft constitution. The committee worked hard and prepared the draft of the constitution, which was presented to the leader of all the parliamentary leader on 20th October 1972. All the leaders signed the draft. After that, it was discussed and debated in the National Assembly, which gave its approval on 10th April 1973. Finally, the Senate approved the Constitution in August 1973, and consequently, the Constitution was enforced in the country on 14th August 1973. According to the Constitution of 1973, Mr. Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto took over as a 10th Prime Minister and Mr. Fazl Ilahi was thrown as a President of Pakistan. Now, salient feature of 1973 Constitution, first of all, written constitution hai, Islamic system hai, the inclusion of Islamic provision has given the 1973 constitution. Rigid constitution means it is not easy to make amendment in a two-third majority of both the houses is required for this purpose or for any change or any thing which people want to amend or change, okay, or make other laws. Federal system hai, the constitution of 1973 has introduced a federal system in the country, means the federation of Pakistan consists of a central government and the four provincial government. The federal government is headed by the president, elected by the member of Majlis-e-Shura, means parliament. Then bicameral legislature structure adopted in 1973 constitutional, that means Majlis-e-Shura parliament consists of two houses named Senate and National Assembly. Senate or the upper house consists of 63 members and the National Assembly consists of 200 members. Then direct method of election means the member of the National Assembly and the Provincial Assembly are directly elected by the people of Pakistan. Then basic fundamental rights adopted, that is 1973 constitution ensures the following fundamental rights to the citizen of Pakistan, means security of person, okay? Safeguard against the unlawful arrest and detention, prohibition of slavery and forced labor, yani koi gulam nahi banega, slave nahi, nobody can make anyone slaves or forcefully ask to provide them labor or work for them. फ्रीडम ऑफ मूवमेंट, फ्रीडम ऑफ बिजनेस, फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच, फ्रीडम ऑफ प्रोफेस रिलीजन, राइट टू होल्ड प्रॉपर्टी और इक्वालिटी बिफोर लॉ, ठीक है, सेफ गार्ड अगेंस्ट डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इन सर्विसेज, इंडिपेंडेंस, ठीक है, ये सारे फंडामेंटल ह्यूमन राइट्स, राइट टू स्पीच, राइट टू वोट, राइट टू एज अ सिटीजन राइट्स, ऑल रिटन एंड सेफ अकॉर्डिंग टू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. देन इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ जुडिशरी मीन्स जुडिशन और कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ 1973 स्ट्रेस अपॉन द एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ एन इंडिपेंडेंट जुडिशरी. फुल जॉब सिक्योरिटी हैज़ बीन प्रोवाइडेड. द जजेज आर अपॉइंटेड बाय द प्रेजिडेंट. They cannot be removed from services before the end of their term except on the recommendation of the Supreme Judicial Council. In addition, the judges are paid respectable salaries. Means they are judiciary independence. They are not under the control of the government. Any government body, any government member or parliament member can also be trialed in the judicial, ठीक है, in the court as well. Then national language accepted. The 1973 constitution has declared Urdu as a national language of Pakistan, ठीक है, और English has been retained. They also adopted that कि English has been retained as an official language for 15 years, ठीक है. Similarly, regional languages and also has also been promoted or protected in their respective provinces. So this is all for today's. Today we discuss few of the successes of Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto's government, means after taking office, became a prime minister of Pakistan. He appointed Fazlullahi as a president of Pakistan and introduced some measure. First task he did was to control the army, then signed Simla agreement with India, and then established a new constitution for Pakistan. Today we discuss these successes. The assignment for today is what was Simla agreement? What was Simla agreement? This is a past paper question, 4 marks question. 4 marks question, you know how to give the answer. When it was signed, in between whom, all the WH answer question. What was the aim behind it? To release prisoner of war. ठीक है, एंड दिस इज द एम, एंड वॉट वॉज द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन यू आर सपोज टू मैंशन इन दिस वन, और वॉट वॉज द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ दिस सिमला एग्रीमेंट. पीपल वर वेरी हैप्पी बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली दोज हुज मेंबर ऑफ द फैमिली केम होम, दे ऑल बी वेरी ग्लैड एंड हैप्पी विद दिस विद द गवर्नमेंट. ठीक है, तो दिस सिमला एग्रीमेंट इंक्रीज हिज popularity within the country. This is the impact. Okay, then describe the term of 1973 constitution. In this one, who presented constitution, when it was presented, mention it, and then the terms they are just asking, so you are supposed to write at least the major term, that is the federal system of government, bicameral structure, fundamental human rights were granted, and language issue and judiciary granted independence and all that. ठीक है, और impact क्या है? It is still implemented in the country. It is still Pakistan is still running on using 1973 constitution. It is a very comprehensive one with few amendment. It is still enforced in Pakistan. So this is all for today's class. I hope you would understand today's lecture. Take care, all of you. Allah Hafiz.